I really appreciate your time. You know, I'm gonna say it all the time, but it's...
Are you kidding? I appreciate yours so much.
Yeah. It's so hard to give a free massage to people. Like, what are you doing? You don't even help me.
That boggles my mind.
Well, like I said, in aesthetic school, massage school, it was the same way. Like, we would try to get people off the streets or in our building.
Yeah.
Like, hey, free massage, you know, $25 for a full hour. Yeah. Where are you going to get that? It was so hard. And these are beautiful girls that like you. And all my classmates were like, yeah, I related pretty much every person in my class. But I kept it professional, you know.
Yeah.
We're in school. Oh, yeah, I definitely would have. But it was even hard getting people off the streets, and as gorgeous as they are,
yeah.
Even, I'm like, damn, really?
I know,
like, I would never say no. Like, and we're right across the street from Tyson's one.
Okay.
The mall, and we would go over there and try to recruit people, or, you know.
Gotcha.
And it was rough.
Interesting.
Such a bright light. I can get a blinder if you need one. Or
it's okay.
Okay.
I'm fine.
I don't know why they call them blinders. Like the horse thing. You know, it's just a, you know, the cover for your eyes.
Yeah.
Yeah, but you're right. If you can find a job that allows you, like right now, I'm only going to office one day a week. Sometimes twice if need be.
Yeah.
But we normally do remote work,
right.
Where somebody always locks themselves out, they don't remember their password, or maybe they forgot to bring their CAT card to work. The CAT card is a common access card, CAC, for certain military personnel. And then, yeah, if you forgot it at home, dude, I can kind of remote. I would have to break protocol and call my boss to do that, but I have to go through a lot of verification to make sure you're who you are. I have to do a FaceTime call. It's a lot.
Do you work strictly with military personnel?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Or sometimes it's outside companies, like if they want people who have like already have like a clearance. So not everybody who works for the government has a clearance. You actually have like a regular job and apply through the state and have workers, you know, have a top secret or secret clearance. It's like four or five different ones.
Oh.
And then there's some secret ones that even I don't even know. Because I've seen people come in our building like, what the hell is that? You know, like, I don't even go in that room. Like,
yeah.
What was that? Yeah, that's crazy. But mainly it's people who get the blue screen of death or the black screen of death. I know they always say a blue screen. It's not always a blue screen. It could be a black screen.
I've never heard of that.
Oh, you don't know what that is. Either the computer's super old or you downloaded so much stuff in your computer where it just shut down just quick. Like, it's too much. And your computer won't operate until you know how to boot it up in a certain type of sequence.
Yeah.
And then erase certain files so your computer can run.
Interesting. I'm talking to this other guy. He's also, well, he just, what is it called? When you, I guess he like retired from the military.
Mm-hmm.
But now he just got a job back with it. He's doing like IT stuff, mm-hmm. like computer science.
Oh, he's up there. Yeah, he's doing good stuff, though.
Yeah.
They probably made him really good.
Yeah. I mean, he's well into his career. He's like 28 now, I think, so.
So he retired young then.
Yeah. He was deployed for a while, though, I know.
Yeah, he's probably getting like a medical. Sort of how I get, for the rest of my life, I get disability. So it's kind of like retirement, but we don't call it, we just say disability.
Okay. Yeah, I'm not sure. Like, it's crazy because everyone around here is in the military, and like, everyone I know is associated with the military. This is like, I don't know anything about it. So I'm like still learning all the lingo and like trying to understand what like everything is. Like, I have no idea.
Well, I mean, you're right though, in the sense that, yeah, we do retire because they still pay us for the rest of our lives, but we didn't do like the full 20 years or 30 years or whatever
right.
Retirements truly are.
Yeah.
Because I think now it's 30 years or something like that.
Oh my
maybe 25 to 30. It's been long now. I'm like, wow. Military has always been 20 until, you know, certain things happen with the stock market, whatever, they changed it.
Yeah.
And that's pretty long, 30 years. But the bonuses are awesome.
Yeah, the benefits. That's what I know a lot of people get into. Like my best friend from college, she is right now getting her master's in dermatology.
Okay.
And so she's going to go to med school soon. And so she's like applying now and such, but she's enlisting in order to get it paid for.
Thank God, yes.
And so I was like, that's interesting. I never would have thought about that.
Well, I'm not saying that most people aren't smart because they don't do that, right? I'm just saying, like, we don't even know what's out there sometimes.
Yeah.
Unless
you don't know the option, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Because some people know, you know, schools are free. When I went to the military, I didn't even think about school. I didn't know it was free. I didn't know. And they don't advertise it when you're in there either. They just, hey, come to work.
Right.
They don't want you getting smart.
Yeah.
Unless you have a good boss, then yeah, they'll look out for you.
Yeah.
Super tight.
Yeah.
Is it too much?
No, it feels good. I've just started running like longer distances now. I'm trying to get my mileage back up.
Mm-hmm.
And so I think that's why my legs are like a little achy and sore.
No, but you're doing good. I mean, I can definitely feel it tight, but there's no like popping or nothing crazy in the leg that I feel.
Yeah.
It's a little sensitive. Let me try to strip out every little thing I can. Yeah, the military is the way to go. But it's not for everybody. Like, my brother didn't go into the military. He had a choice to go to Naval Academy. Got an award letter from the governor at the time because he did something in school. He was in band and he played football.
Oh, wow.
At halftime, he was playing in the halftime.
No, he was.
What the hell?
That's funny.
I wish we had footage. That's the only thing. Like, we weren't rich, so it wasn't like we had a camcorder. I'm like, damn.
Yeah.
Man, those are memories. Like, we could have. Like, who does that? I mean, there's a very select few who do, yeah.
Yeah.
But it's rare, though.
Yeah.
He had a scholarship for band. The band one was higher than the one for football. So
Oh, wow. He
chose the band scholarship. It was 4 years to pay for, room and board, everything.
Yeah.
And the football one only paid for 2 years. It was like a partial scholarship.
Yeah.
So he was smart. He's like, no. And then he got that award letter to go to Naval Academy. And that's kind of hard to do, to go to Air Force Academy, Naval Academy.
For sure.
And Citadel for the Army. You got to get like a congressional letter from somebody.
Yeah.
It's very picky, very selective.
Right.
Unless you're a legacy child, you know what I mean? Like, if our father was an officer and he went to Naval Academy, then yes, we could all plan to go.
Yeah, I have lots of friends like that.
You know, I used to blame them at first, but now I think about them, you know what? I want my children to go.
Yeah.
No,
like, no. I mean, use right. The advantage you got. It's fine.
Please do. Like, because your dad and mom had worked so hard for that, for you to even get there. So,
oh, for sure.
You know, the Navy Army, they helped them. So.
Yeah.
And they recognize that because, yes, it is hard to get quality soldiers, quality Marines, quality airmen, anything. So it's like, yeah, they'll reward certain people.
Right.
Because they're great people. And these are our future leaders. Maybe we'll have your son and daughter, the future leaders. And that's cool. Golden, just let me know if it's too much.